Hey everyone, how are you doing? I was preparing a different video for you today, but turns out I'm overly optimistic with my editing skills, so that will have to wait a while. In the meantime, somebody asked me for a tutorial or explainer video of how I draw flowers, so this is what I'll attempt to give you right now. I bought a bunch of daffodils, so we are going to draw them today. I'm starting by examining the overall shape of the flower and drawing out the silhouette. In this case, it's something like a cone, I guess. I have to apologize that part of my sketch is gonna be cut on the top. I don't really see what the camera is seeing while I'm drawing. That's why this is happening. And yeah, once I put down the overall shape, I just add some details like the petals, some lines, a little bit of shading, and that's it. Oh well, I guess it's not really that simple. Let's try again. And this time I'm gonna be cutting the bottom of the sketch. Sorry. So again, I'm trying to follow the contours. You can do some blind contour exercises beforehand. In general, I don't think this is the proper way of drawing flowers, or probably anything for that matter. It's just the way I discovered it's most comfortable and works for me after drawing a lot of flowers, so I think you'll probably have to do that. Yeah, sorry, not very useful, I know. While doing this, I realized that I'm probably not the best person to ask for a tutorial on anything, because even though I do follow tutorials and have been to a short drawing class, for the most part I'm making up things as I go and adapt to what's most comfortable to me and what makes more sense. But I would say the beginning is the most important. Laying down the silhouette will just guide you through the rest. Adding the details, it's actually not that complicated once you get the basics of it right. So maybe spend more time on the proportions and the overall shape of the flower or whatever you're drawing. And very important, don't start off with the details. Let's try again. So first we observe the flower a little bit, and what I can see is a circle, a cylinder, and then a bigger circle at the base. So this is what I'm drawing. Here the point of view of what I'm seeing and what the camera is seeing is a bit different, so you'll see that it doesn't look exactly the same as the model, but let's go with it. I'm trying to figure out the space that the flower takes. I'm looking at how the petals overlap each other and what general shape they have. It's not a super realistic drawing. It's not a super accurate representation of the flower itself, but it works for me. So yeah, this is how I draw flowers, not how to draw flowers. I guess that's important to note. And once I feel like the shape is right, I just draw the lines with a little more confidence and wait a day. I wasn't very happy with these sketches. the position I had to sit in while filming this was incredibly uncomfortable, so I really wanted to get it done as quickly as possible. But in the end I decided to go for one more sketch, a little more different, where I'm sketching directly with a marker, just to show you that as well. This can also be done with a watercolor or different kind of paint. The idea here is that we're concerning ourselves with shapes and not so much with lines, even though, well, we still don't draw lines. So first of all, I put down this blob of yellow and then started playing with a little bit of shading. I found colors in my small collections that sort of resembles the colors I see on the flower, and added that for a bit of dimension. And in the end, I'm finishing it with this pen, just to give the drawing a little bit of outline and definition. When you watch this in real time, you will see that I don't really spend that much time thinking. I'm just drawing lines, hoping for the best. I wasn't always like that, obviously. At some point, I guess it was some combination of impatience and a little bit of level of experience. So it will take some practice. But if I have to summarize and give you some tips, would be do some blind contour exercises. I totally forgot to show you in here what this actually is. If you haven't heard of it, you can search it. I'm sure many videos will come up. It's basically where you look at the contours of the object you draw and draw simultaneously without really looking at your drawing. You only follow the contour with your eye and simultaneously with your pen. This is not supposed to end up in a actual drawing. It's just an exercise to coordinate your eye to your hand, and what you produce will just look like a bunch of nonsense, but go with it. After you do some of these, you can switch to still doing the blind contour, but once in a while look at your hand as well. And eventually you can try what I'm trying to show you here. I'm not really sure how helpful this is. I realize that probably seems too rushed, and I'm not sure I'm explaining it very well, because now I'm realizing that I myself don't realize exactly what I'm doing, because I'm just doing it, and I probably should have spent a little more time getting clear on my own process before talking to you about it. But well, I guess I just jumped into it right away without much planning. Oh well, don't be like me, don't listen to me, go and do your own thing. But anyway, I guess that's it for this little demo. I hope it was somewhat useful, though I'm worried it probably wasn't. But on the plus side, I'm sure you can find much better resources out there. So don't waste time liking and subscribing, just go and find a better source of information. I would still be happy to see you back here next time when I finally get my editing together. Anyway, hope to see you next time, and until then, have fun!